Dear friends, welcome to Thalir. It means bud. It is budding forth to a new life. And we are Capuchins working for the renewal of the society and the church. Dear friends, welcome to Thalir Capuchin Online Ministries. This is from Salanas KC Animation Center, Bilupuram in India. This is part of BISIT, the Virtual Institute of Skills, Integrity and Transformation. This week, October 12 to 16, we have the international online sessions for the secretaries. We are very happy to have Dr. John Shaker, YFM, and Dr. Anthony Swami, SVD, for training these sessions in this week. They'll be dealing with secretaries' role, responsibility, organizational and interpersonal skills, work ethics, organizational management, time management, and professionalism. And we also will have digital system, color content infographics and posters, followed by mobile-based content creation, shooting, editing, documentation. We will also have practicals on Office 365, creating newsletters, e-cards, and other things. In the coming weeks, we will have special trainings on the capacity building to the secretary's advanced level, and also international training for the teachers, October 19 to 21, and special training for the social work directors on project management and fundraising. And we'll have 1 week of midlife transition, physical, psychological, spiritual well-being. And we'll also have a longer duration of sessions for the novices and the juniors preparing for their vows. Here comes Father John Shaker and Anthony Swami. Welcome to you. Welcome, Father Dr. Anthony Swami. We are very happy to have you. Thank you.
Thank you, Father Nitya. Once again, good evening, dear fathers, brothers, and sisters. A hearty welcome to the digital world. We all are in the digital world. Without digitalization, we can do nothing. Today, right from the marketing, right from the purchasing, or banking, anything, even the education, our spirituality, everything, we are into the digital world. So, we cannot alienate our life from the digital world. Our digital world is very, very important. So, I would like to take just a minute. I will share my screen.
You want us to enter through Zoom in the mobile, Father?
Father, that's better. But when I show some things, no, for the screen is pretty small.
Yes, yes. Okay, okay. Take your time.
Okay. So all of you sharing, see my screen, dear fathers? Are you able to see my screen?
We see you.
Our screen?
Is there any other screen I need to highlight, spotlight, Father?
No, the same screen I'm trying to share. Okay, okay, now it has come. Okay.
Yes.
Now you are able to see?
Yeah. Fine, fine.
Okay. So I began my talk telling that we are in the digital world. Without digital world, we cannot do anything, because we are in such a way got accustomed to the digital world. But we are not able to understand the depth of the digital world, because we are having very limited knowledge, because we are not so much into that digital world, because just we are migrating ourselves from the analog system to the digital world. Since we are migrants to the digital world, it is important for us to know what is the digital world, how does it affect us, and how to handle the digital world. So most of the time, digital world is not just as easy as we think. Sometimes the internet will be working and suddenly it will go off. Sometimes the computer will be working very nicely, suddenly it will go off. Sometimes the mobile will be very nice, but immediately it will not function. But in that situation, how we need to handle the digital world, that is very, very important. Today, I would like to show you what all the digital world we need to learn as secretaries, provincial secretaries or the general secretaries, how we need to equip ourselves, or how we need to be friendly with the digital world, very specially. So we will see. Here in this world today, the $1 billion question is, how can we communicate our knowledge and information effectively in the digital world? Okay, because we are migrating, we do not know much about the digital world. How I am going to communicate my knowledge or communicate my information? Yesterday, Father John Shaker was sharing with us, as a secretaries, always we are in constant communication. Communication with the provincial, communication with the community, communication with the other communities or other provinces and the congregation at large. Means we are in constant communication. So to have that constant communication, I need to have my communication skill very effectively, or my communication skill up to that date. So in this 3 days of seminar, means the first part, we will be learning all these three things. First, we will have understand the digital technology, means knowing my computer and knowing my mobile, anything that we have got digital platforms. Secondly, we will understand the format and understanding of the formats. The formats, when we talk in the digital world, it is not the same. Most of the times when we play a video on the screen, the end of the video, the comment is very nice PowerPoint. Means we are not able to make a distinction between the PowerPoint and the video. PowerPoint is entirely different and video is entirely different. PDF is entirely different and the Word document is entirely different. Excel sheet is entirely different and the JPEG picture is entirely different. We need to know the difference, then only we are able to communicate well with the conference or brothers and sisters in the province. To understand that one, we need to understand the formats. Then also we will learn the designing skills. How do I make use my designing skills into the digital world? Then the designing or the professional presentation. I have been associated with this teaching of the designing 2008 onwards. Till now, whenever I look at the PowerPoint presentation of our religious, most of the time it is very discouraging, because our presentation is not up to the professional field. We are not able to compete ourselves in terms of presentation with the world outside. Means we have not reached up to the professionalism. Father John Shaker was telling us, okay, we are all professionals. We are moving towards the professionalism. Okay, when we are moving towards professionalism, it is better that we learn well. Okay, all of us are good. All of us have got the potentialism. Okay, I am as a potential designer, as a potential editor, as a potential reporter. We all of us have got a professionalism, but how much we are converting that professionalism into the potentialism, into the professionalism, that makes a greater difference. Here comes the digital world very handy. So we will learn how can I move myself from the potentialism to the professionalism. Okay, now I would like to begin by this one class, knowing the digital world. Okay, what we are using, we should know, because we all are migrants. We are migrating from one kind of world to the another kind of world. Here, let me just explain to you. You are able to see me, Father Nitya? You are able to see me? Can you hear me?
Yes, Father. Yes, Father.
Hello,
yes.
Father.
You are visible, Father.
Father, can you hear my voice?
Yes, I can hear you, Father. You can increase little more voice. Maybe it will be better. Little more louder. It looks as though you are in the far away.
Excuse me, Father Nitya, can you hear my voice?
Yes, this is better. This is better. Can you hear us? Yes?
Hello, anyone can respond. Can you hear my voice?
Yes,
am
yes.
Am I audible?
Sir. Yes, yes.
You can open the this one if you want.
Father is not able to hear, I believe.
Yeah.
Your antenna Swami is not able.
Or all, you can open others' mic for some few minutes. Participants, mics. Can you all hear Father's sound?
Yes,
Father. Yes, Father, we can hear you.
Yes,
Father, we can hear.
Not audible, Father.
Not audible.
Not audible.
Not clear.
Yes. Yes. You can raise the volume.
Not clear.
Speaker's volume is not clear.
You can raise the volume.
Yes. We are in the China town market now.
You are clear, Father.
We are not able to get the Holy Spirit.
Yes.
Clear.
Father Antony Swami, are you here? We all hear everybody's voice except yours.
Raise your volume and you will be all right.
Excuse me, Father Nitya, can you hear my voice?
Yes.
Am I audible?
Yes.
Father. Yeah, now you can put off all of them.
Concrete is the one I can manage to Nala and the either one pick up a matter. Adelena was an Allah.
Okay, Father. You can continue. Someone is talking, Father Ben.
Yes, Father.
Okay. Yes, Father Antony. Bear with us, friends. This is a technical things. Because sometimes you have to shift all the things, like not like yesterday's theory. There are so many things. Father, we are audible. You are audible. You can increase. Now you can talk. Father Antony?
Could you hear?
No. Look at us.
Oh, Father, can you hear me?
Now, yes, now, okay.
I can't hear you.
Oh, really?
That's what I said, Father. He is not able to hear.
I see, okay.
Father, am I audible to you?
Yes. You are audible to us. I think I'm right. You are audible.
When I speak, you cannot hear the voice now. I think your speaker is
clear.
Father, am I audible to you?
Yes. Yes, Father. I think he is not. I think I'll contact him.
Hello. Am I audible to you, Father?
Yeah. I am hearing you very clear. Good. Can you see me? Excellent.
So dear father, sorry for the interruption. I was not able to hear your voice. That's why I was asking whether even now I am not able to hear you. Okay, hope you are able to hear my voice. So when we are into the digital migration, it is important that we are understanding the digital world well. So first thing, let us understand the gadgets that we have.
Father, your sharing is stopped, Father.
So we have got the desktop. Then we will understand the internal parts of the desktop and what is the difference between SSD and HDD, because we need to understand what exactly it means. Then we will understand the LAN and the fiber optics, that is the new technology that we have got today. Then let us understand the what is the software, difference between the software and the operating system. Okay, let us understand the desktop. See, most of the time we are working with the desktop. Okay, so when we are talking about the desktop, always we understand in three things. One is the CPU, another one is the monitor, and another one is the commanding board or keyboard or mouse. Here, for us, what is important is not the monitor, but we need to know how the CPU works as we are working more and more in the computer. See, CPU is the one that which is very important for us when we work. If we do not know about the CPU, then we will not be able to work properly. So here, when we are working with the CPU, we need to know the strength. Once we know the strength of my computer, then also I know how much more I can go ahead with my designing field. Okay. Designing field. Here, when we are in the computer, in the CPU, we need to understand in four very important things. One is the processor, RAM, hard disk, and motherboard. So when we are buying a computer, we should have the complete knowledge of these things. If we do not have the knowledge of these things, then we will not know what kind of computer we are buying, or what kind of computer we are using, or what is the strength of my computer, in which extent I can go in the designing field. It is very, very important. So the processor, what we call, is very, very simple. So see, this is the altogether what we have got in the computer, what we have in the computer. But here also there is a different things where we can put, or where we know the strength of the computer. This, you see, these are only small things that we have here, is the one that which is called a processor. So the processor, when we talk about the processor, this is almost 40 to 50% of the total cost of the computer cost only for this. So in the processor, there is a different series and different generations. The series, what we call is series, what we call. Today we have got i3, and each series will have got its own generation. Like i3 will have third generation, i3 will have fifth generation, i3 seventh generation, i3 and eighth generation. The same thing when we talk about the i5, will have the same generation. i5, third generation, i5, fifth generation, i5, seventh, the same thing, i7. Third generation, fifth generation, sixth generation. So when we are buying a computer, please make sure that this one we have in the computer. Whether I have got i5, i7, i9. Most of the times when we ask for a computer, just we ask for a computer, and that fellow will bring and give whatever he wants. Most of the times we do not know what he has put really inside. When you are buying a computer like this, please make sure that you are checking your computer exactly what is there. As a secretary in the provincial province, I would suggest always you go for a computer with a little higher version, like i7 and 7th generation at least. i7, 7th generation, that will have got very good speed in your computer. So the second one is the RAM. RAM is the one that which determines the speed of your computer. Process is the full working of the computer, and the RAM is the speed of the computer. That which is the computer speed depends upon the RAM. Even the RAM, we see the DDR1, DDR2, DDR3, DDR4, these are the different series we have. When you buy a computer, make sure that you are having RAM that which is very much closer to the motherboard, or that which is compatible to the motherboard. Suppose the computer person tells that the computer is high configured computer and gives the DDR1, and he gives a bill, then you should know how to check it up. And also you can cross check in the internet what kind of RAM I have got, what kind of series of the RAM that I have, and accordingly I pay. Here I would suggest for your office the good computer is DDR4. So this is the RAM what we have got, very small thing that you can see. This is the RAM where we have got. This is the one that which makes computer to begin and also to start. Without RAM, computer will not start. Okay, very small things. This is the RAM. You can see which this one. Today in the market, most of the times we see DDR4 RAM as the best RAM. That is the one which is very widely operated today. This is the RAM. Then the motherboard. What I told you is this the motherboard, what we have called. See, this motherboard also has got a different purpose. AT, ATX, BTX, EATX. So a different version. When you are buying a motherboard, you make sure that you are buying a motherboard that which is very recent one. If you are buying the motherboard that which is 5 years back, 5 years old model, then you will have your motherboard will get expired or outdated very soon. Maybe 1 year or 2 year. Then your RAM you will not get. Processor you will not get. When you give for a repair, the computer man will say that this is very old. Okay. So when you are buying a computer, make sure that minimum you are going for ATX motherboard. ATX motherboard is more or less, it is also quite old, but it will support all your i3 series. Whether you take i3 processor or i5 processor, anything that will support.
Father Anthony, okay. Father.
Then another thing is very important is SMPS. Okay, this is the SMPS what we have got in the computer. I will show you at the end, open and show the computer. SMPS, this is the one that which distributes the whole power supply to the computer or to the motherboard, anything what we have. Suppose if you have got a higher version of the SMPS, then your computer will run well. If you have got lower version of the SMPS, then your computer will not run. Sometimes you have got an experience. The moment you put two pen drives, your computer stands still. Okay, your computer hangs. Why? It is because the SMPS is not able to give the proper power supply for all your motherboard devices. Okay, this is the one that which gives. See here, we no need to give which one what. So this is the wire, everything is connected. This wire will have power supply to the fan, power supply to the display board, power supply to the RAM, power supply to the graphic card, power supply to the USB up, power supply to the SATA 4. Everything will be connected here. We no need to check anything. So everything is controlled here. If the power supply is given, proper power supply to the motherboard, then computer will run well. If the power supply is not good, the moment you put two pin drives at a time, the computer will hang. So when you are making a computer, make sure that you are purchasing very good SMPS. Minimum today you go for 450 above SMPS. Don't go for 230, 330. The computer people will tell, "Oh sister, don't worry, this is very nice. This will be more than sufficient." Okay, that's because they want to sell the product lower price, no problem. But for us, it is for us to use as a secretaries in the province or in the provincial office. It is our necessity. We need to use the computer. It is not he one who uses. It is I one who use. So I need a good computer. Okay. So when you are designing, make sure that you are designing well. The graphic card. Okay. The graphic card is always inbuilt in the motherboard. This is the old motherboard. We have got external graphic card, extra graphic card. Whereas today, when we talked about the graphic card, we no need to buy. Already, it is inbuilt in the motherboard. If the graphic card is good, you will have very good output. If the graphic card is not good, then you will have got very poor output. Okay. So your display depends upon the graphic card. Then also, when you watch a movie. In the video clip in the this one computer, if you have got a graphic card, your display will be very nice, okay, very smooth. There will be no grain, nothing. If you do not have a graphic card, means you can find a kind of very dull color, okay, the color will not be rich. Then because of the dull color, our eyes gets very starts getting burned. Okay, I feel a kind of uneasiness even if I spend in front of the computer. Even 10 minutes, I lose my concentration. So to work with the computer, you need a very good display. Okay, so that display is depend upon the graphic card. Then also the display, what we call display, we need to have very good monitor. Okay, if you are working in the provincial office or if you are working in the general office, any office work you are doing, and if you are working most of the times in the computer. Make sure that you are taking a bigger monitor, because the bigger the monitor, the more space I can look around, because I no need to strain my eyes. Okay, I no need to strain my eyes. I have got a bigger place to look. Even at a distance, I can look, I can read, so I will not get tired. So when you are going, at least you buy a monitor of 24 inches. Today we need, because today all the computers what we have got is very macro. So many things are inbuilt. Okay, even the display, what we call the monitor or anything, that is very this one closely inbuilt. This one what you call sensor. Because of that, the radiation we get very fast tiredness or very fast this one we lose the interest. So when you are buying any computer, any this one. Make sure that at least 24 inches of this one you are buying. Maybe a TV, flat TV also will do, or monitor also will do, which has got inbuilt speakers today. You don't need to keep extra speaker. There is a speaker inbuilt in today's display. You buy like that, so that you will you no need to fix extra speakers for the this one. What do you call? For the sound and all those things, everything in one click, everything is there. So, dear sisters, this is So yes, sir, this is the internal parts. Once again, I will tell you, this is the SMPS. You make sure that at least you are buying SMPS of 450 watts above. Don't buy more than lesser than that, because your computer will hang. Because the motherboard today, what we have, what we get in the market, consumes a lot of power. So this SMPS, you go. Then the motherboard, at least you go for ATX or EATX motherboard, little higher version, so that your computer will not get very fast heated up or warmed up. So you will have one very good this one display or the process of working very nicely. So the motherboard ATX and the SMPS 450 watts above. Then the processor depends upon your budget. You can go for the lower budget also. But you go at least i7 seventh generation, so that will be enough. The computer will be very fast enough for working. You will not get bored up. Okay. Then I told you the RAM. You go for DDR RAM, minimum 8 GB RAM you go, 4+4, okay? Two slots will be there. Every computer will have two slots, the this one for the RAM. So you put 4+4, that becomes 8 GB minimum. You can increase your RAM later on, no problem. Then of course the display card and all will be there. This is no problem. Then I told you the this one, what you call the display already. Display is of the monitor. I have the display of minimum 24 inches of the display so that you can work very nicely. Now today's technology is, okay, you must have heard from the computer people, SSD or hard disk. Okay, see, this is the hard disk what we have got in a computer. Okay, this is the hard disk what we have got in the computer. So this always takes a binary reading. Okay, once you click, that has to take a round and it has to, suppose the binary digit, binary reading is 0002, means it has to take 0003 rounds, then you will read the number, or again 2, 1, 2, means 5 rounds it has to take for the reading. That is called a binary reading. Whereas today what we have got is a solid state drive, SSD. Today, wherever the computer you buy, whatever computer you buy, there is SSD inbuilt. This is almost 3 to 4 times faster than the hard disk, because that has got the digital reading. If you hit 1, straight away it will read the number 1. Okay, if you are typing number 9, straight away it will read the number 9. So that is the digital reading. Today, that is the technology what we have got in the market. So that will be something like this, very small. The SSD is very very small. So the maximum you will have 250 GB SSD. You can fix it in the computer. Then 1 TB, another hard disk, extra hard disk you can put, so that you have got operating system very fast running and you can save all your data in the hard disk. Means in the computer you will have both SSD also and hard disk also. The difference between these two is this one. In terms of budget, only this will have 3,700 rupees extra will cost, that much only. But you will enjoy working when you have got SSD in the computer. This is the two different things, a hard disk and the SSD. These two things, what we have got today in the market. Okay, now this is all about computer, what I have been telling you. Okay, the hard disk and the SSD, and I will also show you this is called external hard disk. The external hard disk is nothing, there is one cover outside, that's all. This is also called a laptop hard disk. In the laptop always we see this this kind of hard disk. Only the case is there inside, when we come to the this one, all what are the same. This is a little smaller version. Okay, this one will be there. Something happens to your hard disk. Suppose you are using hard disk, something happened, you have got some problem with your hard disk. Please don't throw. You remove the hard disk from the case and fix it in the computer or in the laptop, and you can copy your data back so that your data is safe, and you can format the hard disk and you can make use again. This is the external hard disk. Even this external hard disk, you can fix it back to the computer also. You can also fix it back to the laptop, no problem. It will work in externally also, internally also. This is this one also, you can use it as external hard disk, but you have to keep or give the power supply externally, then only it will work. Otherwise you can use it in the computer. Okay, then sisters, why I brought the computer here is to tell you, sometimes when you are operating the computer, putting on the computer, just you see that the beep sound will come, ting sound will come, then it will not start. Okay, it will not proceed anything further because there is something wrong. once you start the computer and comes some beep sound, a ting sound comes and stops this, there is something problem with your RAM. Okay, RAM is not working. RAM is not working. So what you have to do, you have to remove the RAM. Just you wipe it very smoothly. Use very gently you handle. Just you wipe it, or you blow, something dust will be there. Again, you can fix it back. Make sure that there is exact way there is fixing the this one. Okay, then you can press and both the side it will be there. Suppose this is I opened, okay. I opened the computer, that's okay. If the computer is closed, how do I remove? You are able to see my computer here. See, when the computer is there, we cannot open both. Okay, only one side you have to open, because at the other side the motherboard will be fixed. Okay, so you should never open the this one part where the motherboard is fixed. For example, when you see there is a display port here, USB display port and all those things. This here means the motherboard is fixed in this side, okay, right side. So you need to open to the opposite side. Okay, always the right side part will be the motherboard. Motherboard will be fixed, and the left side part will be very free. Okay, very free. So once you have got, you will have some screw. Then just you pull it. Just you pull, so this part will come out. So see, this is the where they have connected. So you put your computer down and just you open the RAM. Okay, just you open the RAM and just slowly and gently wipe the RAM. Okay, if you have got cotton cloth or something, that will be still better. Gently you wipe and you put it back. You put it back, then you start the computer, then there will be no sound, the computer automatically will start. Okay, this is the some of the very practical tips we can give in the computer. So today, okay, before that going, there is two types of connectors when we see in the computer. See, this is called HDMI, whereas today in the market when you buy a computer, always you will have HDMI computer, okay? HDMI computer, high definition interface, this one connector. So what is the difference between VGA cable and this one is, VGA cable take only video graphic adapter. Only video it will take, it will not take the sound. Okay, VGA cable will not have the facility to take the sound. Whereas the HDMI cable will have facilities to take the sound also. Okay, you don't need to connect anything separately for the sound. Whereas in this itself, it will get connected. This is one thing. Second thing, when we connect with the VGA cable, mostly you will see here I don't have extra cable. When you see blue color thing, what you have got in the computer, that is called VGA. There will be little 1 inch longer. This is the HDMI. So these are the two different things when we connect. So now I want to tell you about the another technology today what we have got in the market or in the okay, today what we have is the internet connection. So far we have been using the LAN cable for the internet connection. Okay, so far we have got used to with this LAN cable. LAN cable, this is good for the networking, that which is very close by and all, it's okay. Okay, if we are very far and all those things, then we need to think. So here inside this wire there is a copper wires inbuilt. Okay, there will be 6 copper wires. Through that, the internet data will be transmitted. The waveform, it will go to the computer. When it travels, this also has got the speed very limit. Whereas today, okay, Whereas today, you must have heard the fiber optics everywhere. Okay, fiber optics. The connection, because of that, we have got very good speed of internet. The fiber optics and the LAN is only this much different. The LAN cable will have copper wires inside. Through that, the data will be transmitted. Whereas the fiber optics will have like pipe. Okay, there will be no wire inside. There will be like pipe, but in this pipe there will be light that travels. There will be devices from one place to the another place. From one place, one device to the another device, there is a light. That light travels. You see, very very small wire, like our size of little bigger than our hair. Okay, that much only. Whereas in this, the light travels. The speed of the light is always the faster than the waves that is traveled in the copper wire. These are the two different things. Things what we have got today. If you are in the city limits, all the cities we have got the fiber optics today. When you want to take a connection, please opt for the fiber optics so that you will have got very good speed. Like in our institution, we have got fiber optics connection. We have taken 90 Mbps, means 90 Mb per second. We are using more than 25 connections in the institutions. When all the 25 connections are on, our speed is still very nice. At least 50-55 Mbps we will get. That is the advantage of fiber optics today, what we have. Okay, now last but not the least, the software and the operating system. Most of the times we do not know the difference between the operating system and the softwares. Okay, when you are working in the computer in the designing field, then you should know which software to be used and which software not to be used. Okay, what is this OS or the operating system? Where today when we see, we have got Windows 10. Okay, earlier that there used to be XP, there used to be Windows 7, XP, after XP there was Windows 8.1. Okay, now Windows 10 we have got. So operating, without operating system, computer will not run. Okay, so that is the basic software that which makes computer run. That is called operating system. What we have got Windows 10. Then the software is the individual softwares, individual apps or individual programs that we install again in the computer. So like PowerPoint, okay, Microsoft Word, Microsoft Office, these all come under the individual softwares. Okay, Photoshop, AutoCAD, Premiere, these all come under the individual softwares. Okay, when you are working in the office, you make sure that at least you have got Windows 10. Please make sure that you are getting a licensed version. When you have got licensed version, automatically it gets updated, automatically it gets repaired. Anything, any problem, online they do it, no problem. That problem will not cost much until and unless you have got a hardware crash or something. Okay, where a software also, you don't need to buy all the software's license. At least you buy Microsoft Office 365 license version. That will have got all the things inbuilt in it. Today, with that Microsoft Office 365, where we are going to learn tomorrow, day after tomorrow, we are going to learn more and more. In that, you can design an invitation card, you can design a newsletter, you can design a calendar, you can design a memo. Okay, name it, whatever you want, everything is there. Okay, inbuilt. So that license doesn't cost much. Office 365 to cost around 1,800 to 2,000 rupees. Okay, once we buy, it will be for us always. So that is one thing. Secondly, once we buy 365, there is one drive. Okay, one drive means we will get 1 TB cloud space along with this one. You can save everything in your cloud space. Anywhere you can access to your file. Suppose you are working in the computer and you can say you saved in the OneDrive or the cloud, then you are going somewhere else, you have mobile, through the mobile you can access to your data what you did in the computer. That is the advantage of buying Office 365 licensed version. We have got all the options, as well as we have got the 1 TB data, cloud data that we can stored. Okay, dear sister, this is the sum. Some things about the computer that we have been discussing. So, if you think, if you ask me a question, if you ask me a question, what is the what about the laptop? Okay. We have been discussing about the system or the computer. Then what about the laptop, if you ask? So in the laptop also same process what we have been discussing till now. The processor is the same, but it will be micro, the motherboard, RAM, graphic card, the sound card, everything is the same. Okay, but everything is in a macro in a fine format. But when we are trying to buy a laptop today, always you go for at least i5 series. Don't go for 2D core or the lesser i3. These ones you don't go, because very soon the i3 is going to be outdated. It will be out of market. Today, when I see the computer people, no, they go to the convents and the fathers, easily they sell the product. They tell that this is the good, you buy, then fathers, they buy it. Yes, they buy it because we are not at all aware of the cost, aware of that is whether it is getting outdated or not. That is the reason these fellows are able to tell. So year after, if you are buying buying a laptop, make sure that you are having the i5 processor, at least i5 fifth generation minimum. Then you will, your laptop will be up to date and you can use another 5 years without any problem. So one tip for the people, those who are using the old laptop, okay? Old laptop, you have got a hard disk, okay? Hard disk means this is the flash drive. Okay, this is the hard disk what you have got in the laptop, if you have got this hard disk. And you have also have got the CD drive, okay? CD drive. Okay, whereas now, today, CD drive is not used much. Okay, CD drive is not used much because we use more and more the pen drive. Now here, what we have got, the laptop, the motherboard connects both. The hard disk also it gets connected and the CD drive also it gets connected. So you no need to have the CD drive at all. Okay, what you do, you remove the hard disk from the laptop. Okay, remove the hard disk from the laptop and remove the CD drive from the laptop. Okay, there is a small case. Okay, for example, the case. Okay, this is a kind of small case. Okay, like this case will you will get, that is like 200 rupees or something. Okay, you put your hard disk inside this case. Okay. You put this hard disk, your hard disk inside this case and remove the CD drive and you put this case where the CD drive is there. Okay. So this hard disk will get connected where the CD drive was there. So now you have removed your hard disk, the hard disk space is empty. So what do? You buy one SSD of 250 GB or 120 GB also, so okay. That costs around 3000 to 4500 if you are buying 250 GB SSD, that will cost you around 4,500 rupees. Okay, instead of that, if you are buying 120 GB SSD, that will cost you around 3,200 or something. Okay, these are the two things. So you put that SSD in the place of the hard disk where your laptop earlier you had. Then you see the difference. You will feel like really the laptop is very fast. Okay, you will feel a lot of difference in your laptop. If you are having the older laptop and where your laptop is very slow, it is not working, and you have got your CD drive, okay? You remove the CD drive and by you can tell the computer man, he knows the case, hard disk case. So you put the hard disk in the case and remove the CD drive and put the face of the CD drive, okay? Then in the place of hard disk, you put one SSD. SSD that will make your computer run very fast. Laptop very fast. So you will have got very good laptop. So dear sisters, today we will learn. Okay, this. Okay, now I will give you, since we were dealing with the so-called digital world, okay, we can have some discussion. Okay, if you have got any question to be asked or something, please let me know. I can answer. Okay, then we will go for the designing field. See, here there is one question. Father, motherboard is gone. What to do in the laptop? Sisters, you see, in the laptop, when you talk about the motherboard, there are different elements in the motherboard. You see, whether it has gone the display board or the RAM board or processor board. So these are the main three things. It gets very fast affected. If something happened with the processor and the connection, then you may have to change the whole motherboard. There is no repair. If there is something to do with the RAM, okay, RAM board, something is happening. Something happened to the RAM board or RAM panel has got some problem, some connection. You can always rectify. You can remove the RAM board and you can put. For example, I'll show you very closely. See, if the motherboard has got some problem with this one, this is the main processor. Okay, this is the old motherboard, so it is like this. It's very well inbuilt. Okay. If something happens around this area, you will not be able to rectify. You have to change your motherboard. Okay, you have no other choice. If something happens with this RAM panel, okay, here something happens. Okay, RAM, this panel is black, no? This panel, something happens, you can remove and you can change. If you happen something to do with this connector, something, you can change. Okay, you can change. Or if you have got anything, this is called the display board. If something happens to this display board, you can change. If your audio is not coming, some problem with this audio here, you can change the audio, no problem. Okay, this motherboard can. Then also there is a port. This has got the older port. If something go on, see here, there is very minute this one. We have to solder it. The fellows, they will remove and solder. Okay. They make the problem. So, why motherboard gets affected in the laptop is because most of the time I have seen, very especially with the sisters and so on. So they will be working like this. They will take and give like this, take like this. Okay, very fast going and holding one hand like this. They will be talking and like this. Now, see, when the laptop is on, the whole processing board will be on vibration. Okay. We should not shake much. The little bit of shake, little bit of touching of the another circuit, anything, the inter circuit, no? Touching whole motherboard will get spoiled. So please don't lift your laptop and you use as you want when it is on. When it is off, no problem, okay? Because the vibration won't be there. The electric passing, no? That won't be there. Whereas if it is on, when you are making, then there will be problem. Motherboard always gets crash because of those things. Otherwise, motherboard will not have any problem. Okay, see here, how do we know what exactly is the problem? Okay, now until and unless we know very well about the computer, we will not be able to But one thing you do, normal, our normal this one, what problem comes is with the RAM. We may have a little bit of shake, that RAM gets loosened. So RAM will not sit exactly on that. Okay. It will not it will not get the proper this one in the RAM. That is the reason it has got this one. Okay, here, what is the full form of SSD? Solid state drive. Okay, solid state drive. This has got a digital reading. So the moment you type anything, it will not go for rounding. Straight away, it will return the number and it will read. The difference between the SSD and hard disk is this one. Almost 4 times it is faster than the hard disk.
Other sisters, if you have got any questions, you can raise your hand or you can write in the chat box for the Antony Swami will be able to help. For the Ben will be able to guide us. For the Antony Swami, can you ask for the question or not? Some clarifications. Do you hear me?
Yes, Father. Yes. Yeah.
Now we'll go for some clarification or you are something else to complete?
No, since we are dealing with the hardware, we'll go for clarification for some time,
yes,
then go
yes.
for designing. Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
Good.
Okay, Anjali Naik is asking this question, Father. How will you know that that is i5?
Oh, okay. Now, so sister, just let me share my another screen because I am using the Apple laptop. Okay, I will share my screen. So you are able to see my screen?
No, Father, it is not shared.
Okay, now.
Fine.
Okay, so see, you click on the My Computer. Once again, I'll share. There is some problem. Okay, sisters, now my computer is not accepting. When you click on the right click on my computer icon, okay. Now you see, you click the My PC or My Computer. I have gone through another because the display I cannot share. That is the reason. So I go to My Computer or My PC and I give on the properties. Click on the properties. So we will have another window display. Okay, you see this this display will be there. Then here you can see here the installed memory, 16 GB RAM. You see processor i7 and fourth generation, i7 fourth generation. See, this is 16 GB, 64-bit operating system. Okay, so you will have all your information here. Okay, in this my computer, right click. Okay, my computer, right click, and you see here the so on i7, and next to i7 whatever comes, that is the generation. Here 4700 means it is closer to 5, so we calculate as a fifth generation. If it is 5770 or 780, means it is sixth generation. Okay, if it is 7, that will come on the seventh generation. So here another thing, since we opened this screen, if you want to know whether your Windows is genuine or pirated, okay, you click on the change product key, or here also you can click on the activation. I will go through this change product. Okay, I give yes. Okay, once again, I have to share other screen. Okay, now you see here at the end, you see activation, edition, Windows 10 Enterprise activation. Windows is activated with a digital license. Okay, if it is there, Windows is activated with a digital license, means your Windows is genuine. Okay, your operating system is genuine. If it is comes, your Windows is activated with this one, what you call your community license, or your team digit, or something like that, team, community, or some other organization, means that is a pirated one. Okay, this is the two different things where we can find out whether the window is activated or not. Other way also, we can also know the this one, if the window is activated or not. Just you run the script and you type. Okay, I will reshare my screen. Okay, you see, when you go to the run script and you write slmgr.vbs/dli, so this will be there. See, here window is activated. Okay, it is given the partial product key, and window is licensed. It says window is licensed. If the window is not licensed, there will be one this one. You will have got 4500 minutes remaining, or 200 days remaining, 100 days remaining. Means within that 100 days, your windows will get expired. So you have to reactivate the window. So yeah, these are the two things where we can make this one. The script to know is, you go to the starting bar and click on the run command. Once you click on the run command, there you write slmgr, okay, .vbs/dli, and give an enter. So your whole thing will be shown here.
There is some question, I think, from Bethany Convent.
Yes, Father.
Somebody is raising the hand, I think, for Bethany Convent.
Yes.
I tried to unmute them. They are not unmuting.
They can unmute, sister.
Yeah.
The last one.
Our sister is there.
Stop. Yes, when the screen gets corrupted, what is the other choice we have?
Screen means your display.
Laptop screen, or yeah, display screen.
Okay, sir. See, the screen, no? When you are using the screen, okay, please don't put not even a single piece of a nail on the screen. Okay, it is very, very minute. Even if you are touching, you touch with your flesh. It has to touch with the skin, not on the nail. our screen gets very fast damaged, it's because we give a hard touch on the screen. One thing. Second thing, how the screen reads is, there is a small little line, okay? There is a color coding, RGB, three color coding. So that runs from here, it begins, red color goes, and begin green color and blue color. So starts from here and ends from here. Means that is called one process. Okay, if there is some damage in between, there is line cut. Okay, line cut. So that graph will not move. So that part you will see the blank space. What happens? Slowly, slowly you will feel that blank space bigger and bigger and bigger. One day you will not be able to see the screen. If it is gone, one thing you can change the display. Okay, you can change the display of the laptop. And if you think that you are you no need to change the display, you can also connect. There is a connector here. You can also connector here. You can also connect this one to the another monitor. Okay, you buy one more monitor. One more monitor and the display will cost more or less same. If you have got one more monitor or TV in your convent or in your this one, this laptop can be connected there. No problem. It will detect. These are the two things we can do. But try to avoid using the nail on the screen. Just you touch, small little touch, okay, nail. Then also make sure that sometimes we may keep pen drive or something and just we close. Okay. When we close, this pen drive got a hard hits on the screen and screen will go.
Brother, could you speak about antivirus?
Okay. So, dear fathers and sisters, today, as of now, you don't require as such the antivirus, because the Windows 10, when we buy license, there is also inbuilt Windows security. Okay? Windows security we have. So, that Windows security will protect your computer. Protect your computer, no problem. If at all you want to put by all the means antivirus, you can put like a net protector, that is one of the best. You can have you can have the total security, this one, net protector. But you should know way that net protector works. If you do not know, sometimes the net protector will block. Sometimes you may be typing your Microsoft Word, the net protector will block, because we download so many files that net protector will detect that as a virus. Because of that, it will block. So you know which one to keep open, which one to block, like, and all the things. Whereas, inbuilt Windows 10, what we call firewall, what we say firewall, that will prevent all the unwanted softwares if it is a licensed version. We don't need to worry about. Today, the antivirus is not necessary, actually. Not necessary. Without that also, it will run.
For Windows 10 operating system licensed version reduces the speed of the laptop because of the update every now and then. What can we do?
See, there also Windows 10, there are different versions, Pada. You see your laptop built for what? Okay? See, like Windows 10, Windows 10 Home Basic, Windows 10 Professional, Windows 10 Premier, Windows 10 Enterprise. Enterprise is the latest one. When you are using Professional and above, okay? Professional and above, that has got a lot of graphic inbuilt. Okay? Inbuilt graphic, your laptop may not be supporting that, motherboard is not able to support all the graphics that is automatically updated. Okay, one thing. Second thing, your RAM may not be able to adapt itself to the new graphics. Okay, either you have to change the RAM or you need to do something with the processor. So, to avoid the confusion, what you do, you see your laptop, the condition, accordingly you put the Windows license. So your laptop is lower version, you put Home Basic, that is enough. Windows 10 Home Basic is more than sufficient. Or Windows 10 Professional is okay, more or less all the laptops, the Professional will run. But don't put Premier, Windows 10 Premier and Windows 10 Enterprise. That will have a higher graphic.
Question from Father Josh Bhaskar.
Josh Bhaskar, go ahead.
Father, thank you. Could you please say something about printers?
Printers? Okay.
Yeah.
So, printing, when we talk about the printing, there are two kinds of printings. One is the inkjet printing, another one is the laser printing. Okay? Inkjet is, there is ink, the bottle ink, we need to fill and we print one thing. Another one is the laser, there is a powder. So, these are the two things. What is the difference between the inkjet and the laser is, inkjet, if you are taking a printout and something, water out, something falls, that ink will get diluted. Okay, that ink will get diluted. Even when you take a printer with a inkjet, you may feel now it's so nice. After 6 months, you see already it will be very fading. That will fade away. But very cost is very less, like 3,500 or 4,000 also, you can get the inkjet printer, no problem. Okay, whereas the laser printer, the good printer will cost you 8,500. That a Canon 1030 is there, or HP, or Xerox Workspace. This and all more or less of the same. That the basic model, 8,500 to 9,000 like that. That is ordinary print. Even the laser jet, there are two varieties. One is the ordinary print. Second one is the multi. Okay, multi, you can scan, you can Xerox, you can send fax. Okay, these all the things come under commercial. That means product. So the minimum, this one is at least 13,500 rupees you will cost if you are going for the laser jet multi. Okay, the Canon will cost best. Today best is the Canon. Or second thing, if you come, you can take on Samsung or HP. That can be another this one. Sometimes our these fellows, what you call computer fellows, will come and pester us. No, you take the printing called there is a printer called Xerox Workspace. Okay, Xerox Workspace, or there is one called Brother. Okay, these are two companies almost getting outdated. Whatever they produce, they wanted to sell in the market, they will come and tell you, please make sure that when you are buying, either you go for a Canon, or you go for HP, or you can go for Samsung. These are the three things you can go. Even Samsung is not very familiar in the market, but it is there. Canon and HP, these two are very common. So inkjet and the laser. In the laser, again, two. One is the ordinary, another one is the multi. Even in the inkjet, there are two varieties. One is just one color, black ink you will get. Another one is three color. RGB. Inside there will be three bottles where you can fill three colors. That will cost you around 11,000 something. Then there is a four color. Okay, four color. There will be four color you can fill. That will cost you around 18,000 plus. So these are the different printers where we have. Then nowadays, you no need to start the computer. Even from mobile, you can give command from the Bluetooth itself. Now, present laptop, everything is with a Bluetooth device. You no need to go to the computer and download the computer and do all those things. No need. Just you click from your mobile, it will print.
Yeah, Father.
Yes, Father.
Seema is asking this question. How to understand the DDR version?
DDR, okay. Father, as I told, no, in my computer, my PC, right click, okay. Right click, in that it will be shown which is the RAM, DDR2, DDR3 or DDR4, okay? Then you will have got the this one also, what is the RAM memory, everything will be shown. Here, like now, installed memory 16 GB, like that, where in that there will be shown. If it is not shown on your screen, then on the RAM, each and every RAM, it will be written. DDR1, DDR2, which version it will be written on that. So if you are increasing the RAM, you can increase. Suppose you have got 2 GB RAM in the computer, you can remove the 2 GB RAM and you can put the 4 GB RAM also or 8 GB RAM also. But make sure that you are putting the same. DDR3 means only DDR3 will work. Other RAM will not work. If DDR4, only DDR4. It will not, other RAM will not support with that.
Angel Rani is asking this question, Father.
Yes, suppose, sir.
Suppose if I have to reboot my actually format the computer, that's what she means.
Okay,
now, how do I take the backup of my file?
Okay, now when we are starting a computer, there is something called C drive. Okay, C drive is meant for the operating system only. C drive. So you don't keep any of the confidential thing, very important file on the desktop. You don't keep downloads, don't keep my pictures, don't keep my documents, don't keep, because all this, a desktop, my computer, desktop, my documents, downloads, pictures, these all these things consist space in the C drive. So you always store your files in the D drive or E drive. Okay, why it is there? Something happens to your computer, you no need to take backup anything, just you format the C drive. Okay, format the C drive, the computer will be again new. But your file that which is in the D drive or F drive or E drive, other drives will be very safe, that nothing will happen to the files. Nowadays, you no need to depend upon the computer man. We ourselves can do. Tomorrow I will show you. I will connect, I will disable the Apple laptop and I will connect with the Windows laptop, Windows computer. I will show you within no time how you can format your computer by yourself. You no need to call someone else and pay money. Yeah, on the same place, you can sit and you can format by yourself. So online, everything is done. You connect the internet and you leave it, automatically it will format and everything it will do. But make sure that you are not keeping any file in the C drive. Desktop, my documents, downloads, my pictures, my videos, these all the things consist space in the C drive, that is the operating system drive space.
Ben, I think there is one question from Rathini Convent.
Yeah, I unmuted them. Yeah.
Father, on the laptop,
yeah,
the touchpad.
Yeah.
It doesn't work. What is the other opportunity? We have mouse to use.
Sister, see, there are two things. Give and the touchpad.
1 minute. Sometimes the keys of the laptop doesn't work. Like not all, some few. So what is the other choice? Whether we have to change the full laptop or only the keys, and also of the computer keyboard.
Okay. So here are two things. One is the touchpad. Another one is the keyboard. When we talk about the touchpad, see, we are working very fast in the laptop. We do not know the shortcut keys what we touch. Okay. Sometimes when we press the Alt function and we press some other key, then the keypad gets locked. Okay. This touchpad gets locked. It means the touchpad has not got, but we have locked the touchpad. That's all. We need to find where which key I have pressed, and you press the same key. Because this shortcut depends from laptop to laptop. HP will have different shortcut, Samsung will have different shortcut, and Lenovo will have different shortcut. Okay, each and every laptop will have different shortcut. You see whether you have locked the touchpad. One thing. Second thing, if the touchpad has gone, you can change the touchpad. Okay, if you don't want, you can use the mouse, no problem. Okay, that thing. Another thing. The keypad getting jammed, no? That is a very common thing with our religious, because we work with a lot of tension. Okay, when we work with a lot of tension, we don't use the keys very gently. Tuck, 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 no? Like this, I hit the key. Tuck, 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 I hit. So that has got a very minute thing that gets stuck. Okay, gets stuck. So that key will not work, or when you put on, there will be some noise, like ambulance, like, no? There will be noise. What you do? You take a small pin, any key stuck, no? Small pin, just slowly, gently, just you lift the key. Make sure that you are not taking out the key, just you pull out. When you see that it is equal to other keys, and leave it. That will work.
There is one question in my box.
Yes, what madam?
To do when the battery is bulging?
I wanted to talk to you about that. Dear fathers, brothers and sisters, most of the time we use the laptop. Sometimes when we are in a hurry, we don't take our charger, we forget and go. Okay, first thing, that is normally happens. We forget our battery and go. When we go to the new place, we don't have any charger. I use any charger that I that is compatible to my laptop. That is one of the wrong way of handling my laptop, because the charger of my laptop and the charger of another laptop, the circuit will be different, the flow of the electricity will be entirely different. Okay, my battery needs 10 volt, needs only 10 volt. Sometimes the other charger what I use that may have the 12 watts or 15 watts or 12.5. So that charger will work in my laptop, but the inflow of the electricity is different. Okay, the electronic that wave is entirely different. Because of that, I lose my battery this one connection. One thing. Second thing, how the battery life is calculated is, this is called process. Okay, from the process from 0 to 100 is the process. Again, 100 to 0 is called one process. Suppose your battery is 0%, you are charging up to 100%. Okay, so you are using, your battery comes down to 0% means your battery used one roundabout. Okay, one process of round. Like that, each and every battery will have 100 process or 200 process, 150 process. If you are making use of that laptop 0 to 100, 100 to 0, 100 times, means you lose your battery. Means you have to buy another battery. To avoid that one, make sure that you are using the same charger for your laptop one thing. Secondly, don't allow your battery to drain less than 20%. Okay, you should not complete the process. Okay, complete the circle. Circle. You should not allow the battery to complete the circle. You stop with 20%. If the 20% is there, you put the charger in. Secondly, you don't allow your battery to charge 100%. 90, 95, enough. You stop your charging 95 because it is not going to 100. Means your circle is not complete. It is not coming less than 20, means zero it is not coming. So your circle is not complete. Okay, so your battery backup will be there, will be always good, and also circle will remain. You can use your battery for the longer run. So that battery bulging comes because of over using of the electricity in the battery. That is the best thing to avoid using the other chargers.
That's one question more in this. I think probably we are getting time in 2 minutes time. Official close, then we can still continue for 10 minutes.
Yeah, sure.
The question for me, given in my box, is sometimes one of the keys keep running, same thing, like example, PPPP, the same thing for 10 times. What to do? Do we have to replace the keypad?
The same thing what I was telling the other side now means it is a little bit pressing, it runs 10-15 times P means the keypad has got pressed a little bit. Okay, that keypad has got pressed. Either while typing you touch very gently, little bit you touch, or you take a small pin and lift the key little up. Okay, it has to be one level. Already it is touching the pad and you are pressing, little bit pressing, already it will sense like you are pressing for a longer time. It's already touching. So either you touch very gently or you lift that key little up. That will be all right. Because of one key, you no need to change the whole keypad. Mm-hmm. The key, this one has got fully gone down and it is not able to pull it up, then you can change the keypad.
Yes, one more question, Father. In my box, the Clarician sisters from Sri Lanka, they want to ask.
Yes, Father.
Sisters, they yes, can Father. Ask.
Yeah.
Father,
yes, can we hear me? Yes, sister, I can.
Father, we are using Canon printer.
Yeah.
And so it connected with another laptop also. We have a desktop and laptop also. So when we are trying to take printout from the laptop,
yeah,
it doesn't come.
Okay.
So what we can do, Father?
So, sister, when you are going to the print, that print screen, you see upside the printing source, which one? Sometimes the laptop will have the default source, default printing it will take. So, you need to give the same printer that which is connected or that which is installed. Suppose if you are giving printout, you see, make sure that Canon, the number will be there. Each and every printer will be having number. Canon P050 will be highlighted on that. If that is not highlighted, or some other printer is highlighted and that printer is not on, means it will not print.
But it is there, no, father.
Which one, sister?
The Canon, that computer already highlighted.
Highlighted?
But
not taking. Are you trying to print with a Bluetooth or Wi-Fi?
Wi-Fi,
okay. Means you check that your Wi-Fi is in the same router connection. Same router connection. Suppose that Wi-Fi has got router connection and you are using your mobile data and connecting the laptop and trying to print also, it will not take. Because the IP address that which is installed in the, taken in the printer and the IP address that which is connected in the laptop should match. That is called a networking, this one system, no? That takes, if it is the same system, connected everything, it will take.
Thank you, father.
Otherwise, sister, you disable the Wi-Fi and again you start, sometimes it will work. Automatically, it will take up the IP.
Okay. Father, in that case, how to do with the Bluetooth?
Bluetooth also same thing, sister. You pair your device with the laptop, so in the with the printer, okay? Put on the printer, there will be Bluetooth, this one in the printer, you put on the Bluetooth and put on the mobile. So, the Bluetooth of the printer will be detected in your mobile. You give yes, then there will be one number shown on the printer. That number also will be shown in the mobile. You press on the mobile, so that both will be paired and it will be connected.
Thank you so much, father.
Welcome, sister.
Father Ben, we can close for this officially and we can continue some other questions.
Yes, father.
Dear friends, we officially wind up now because this is already some sisters have to go for other commitments, fathers also are there. So, but we'll continue tomorrow also, but the questions can be asked, maybe some more questions they can ask, clarify the matters. This is very important because for some people who already done the MSc, MCA, all this kind of BCA, for them it may be easier, but for us, for many other people, it's a very, very helpful. And thank you for Anthony Swami. We are very grateful to you. Tomorrow also you will be continuing. With this, we'll wind up officially, but still questions are there. In my own box, there's one more question. If you are telling there is an inbuilt antivirus software, then is it necessary to install antivirus software separately because we are running antivirus installation every year?
Yeah. Actually, father, it is not necessary tell now. If you have got Windows 10, Windows 10, that is the advantage is there is inbuilt antivirus already. Okay. What happens? When we install the antivirus software externally, like NetProtector or anything, automatically that will take the prevalence and the inbuilt antivirus will be put it off. The firewall will be off. Automatically it will off. The installed antivirus will start working. Mm-hmm. Okay. So why to waste money simply? So instead of that, we can activate all the inbuilt Windows 10, this one, that will do well.
Okay. Father Ben, you can continue.
Father, it is about the pen drive.
Yes, father.
Pen drive is got corrupted. Then how to recover the file? At the same time, if the pen drive has a virus, will it affect the Windows 10?
No, the moment when you put the pen drive, the Windows firewall will detect your virus, okay? Sometimes some virus will be very powerful, so Windows firewall may not be able to detect, but those virus will not affect any of your softwares. Okay, sometimes it will corrupt the files, but it will not affect the softwares. That is the one thing. Secondly, if your pen drive gets corrupted and take the pen drive and you scan it in the place where there is antivirus installed, very specially there is a, so what you call a net protector. net protector also there is the, there are 2-3 net protector antivirus, network net protector NP security, NP total security. There are 3 versions. Always you need to go for the higher version. The total security means it will have all the facilities in that. Sometimes we see the computer man will tell, sister, this is only 200 rupees, sister. We are very happy. Within 200 rupees, we are getting the antivirus. So we install. Actually, the 200 rupees, what we are getting is only the antivirus. When we put some input device, that will scan, that's all. It will not do much work. Then there is a security. Okay, PC security. There is also total security. If you have got total security and your pen drive got corrupted because of the virus and you scan in that software, so that will be rectified. So when you put the this one, there will be folder called data zero. Okay, data zero. You open that folder, all your files will be in that. Then you copy and put it outside. That is one. Suppose your pen drive is fully corrupted, there is no other reason. There are softwares called data recovery softwares. Okay, my data recovery, pen drive data recovery, like that. So you install the software and run your pen drive in that software. But that software will detect all the data that you have deleted. You should not format. Once you format, the circle ends there. If you have not formatted and just you have deleted, then that recovery software will run and it will take even 1 year, 2 years back, what the photos, anything you deleted, that also will come. Only thing, you will not get the same name what you have put. Okay, you will not get same folder. Okay, suppose all the Microsoft Word file will come together. There will be number 001, 002, like that, the number will be there. All the photos will be there together. Then you have to search and take whatever you want. That is how we can recover our lost files.
UFC, Sisters of Holy Cross Convent, Bhopal. Father.
Yes, Father.
Why Word document does not open in the laptop?
Okay.
How to connect the printer to the laptop?
Okay, see, nowadays, Father, all the printers will be using the USB, okay, USB drive. So just same like pen drive, you put the printer store also, but you have to install the drive. Without installing the drive, the printer will not work. Okay, even the Sri Lankan sisters, they were asking, it is not taking, you know. Maybe sisters, the Sri Lankan sisters, you have not installed the drive, the printer driver in your laptop. That is the reason it is not printing. You have to install the printer driver. Then when you give printer, that printer will be detected. You select the printer and give a print, it will print. Okay. Second, why document doesn't open in the laptop? Sister, if you have got Microsoft Office installed in your laptop, surely it will open. Okay. One thing. If your Microsoft Office you have got 2007 or 2010, okay, or up to 2016 if you have the Microsoft Office and you are receiving a file from the Microsoft Office 360, that is the latest version, and there while saving, there is some setting we need to take care of while saving, whether it is an open source or closed source. If the person wants to save as the closed source, you will not be able to open in the lower version. You have to open only in the higher version. If it is saved as an open version, then you can open in any other version, it will open. But make sure that you have got Microsoft Office in your laptop.
There is a question for the Ben in my box. Sister, yes, I think Shanta Mary Anaprakasam. That is out. How about Windows 7? Do the Windows 7 has the inbuilt antivirus? Do we need to install the antivirus?
Okay. So far, Windows 7 has no antivirus inbuilt. Okay, that is the lower version of the Windows. If you are having Windows 8 or 8.1 or Windows 7, you have to put antivirus.
Separate.
The antivirus inbuilt only in Windows 10 Professional. okay, professional or premier or the enterprise. If you have got Windows 10, Home Basic also you need to install.
Okay, there one more question. How to remove the hard disk from the laptop?
Okay. So this is a bit technical, Father. We need to know the certain hardware techniques, otherwise we will not be able to remove. See here, there is a screw, okay? Screw is there. You open this screw, okay? This plate will come out. Once you come out, there will be another clip, small little like this, you will have another clip. You have to open this clip. See, even this clip also has got a screw here. Here, no? Inside that one, you have to open. Then there is a very minute connector is there. You have to take that connector very gently. We have to remove the connector and you lift the hard disk, it will come. There will be spring. Okay, you have to slowly touch the spring, the this one, hard disk will come up. So you have to be very careful removing this screw and removing the connector. So the connector will be connected here. Okay, yeah. Since I am using two computers, I got this. See, connector will be here. This will be very minute. You have to take very slowly. Then also you see, there is here something called a lock. You have to unlock first. Otherwise, you cannot pull out. You have to, such a way you have to unlock that, it comes very easily.
The one question is that if Adi said, this is from St. Joseph. The earlier question was from Karnalayam. This is from St. Joseph. Father, you said Windows 10 inbuilt antivirus. Yeah. Have we to activate it or is it activated automatically?
Father, by default, it will be on. Okay, otherwise, we have to put on. Now, I will share my another screen. Just I will show you how to put on.
Father Ben, do you have some questions in your box?
I think almost I have coupled the questions, Father.
Wonderful, wonderful. This will be the last question then.
Okay, then I'll share my screen, Father.
Yes, Father, yeah.
Okay, Windows Security. Okay. Now you are able to see, this is called Firewall Network Protection. Okay? So here, by default, here you see, firewall should be on, okay, private network, this is the domain network, firewall should be on, here it should be on, okay, this all the things should be on. If it is off, this nothing will happen, okay, it will not protect. If this one is off, the network, this settings and all will be off, the firewall, this is off, automatically there will be message from your computer that please enable the firewall. Enable the firewall. Every half an hour, it will keep on prompting. See, here there is a device security, okay? If this is there to do with the motherboard, so this and all, it has to be memory integrated, this and all, it has to be on. See, security features available on your device that uses visualize based. Why I have kept off this one? Because I was installing some software. Okay. Once I install, till I get the software cracked, this has to be off. That is the reason I have kept off. Whereas you are this ones, all these things will be on by default. Make sure that this is at least on. Firewall is on. So once these things are on, then no problem. So if off, sometimes it will be like this, no? Okay, now you are, firewall, defender, firewall is off. Okay, off means now any virus can enter. So these things you need to put it on. So it has to be on. Okay, everything is the same. Here there will be current thread and all those things will be shown here.
Oh.
You also need to keep your Windows up to date. So if the Windows outdated, then you will not be able to get. For example, I will show you. Windows update setting, okay? Okay, good that I have. Uh, Okay, now you see, you have to keep checking this one. This has to be up to date. Okay, this has to be up to date. Here the update is available because I have not updated my this one. So usually once in 3 days I check, because I have got a license, so I no need to worry. Just I keeping on doing my updates. So this one you have to see to that here it will come green color. This is yellow. Yellow means the update is not done. Computer is not up to date. Okay, not up to date. I need to update. So you check. You go to the this one search bar now. Type search. Just you type on the update and security. So this window will open and you check here. Then you give download. See here it is there download. You click on the download. Automatically it will get downloaded. Then it will be installed. Then you give restart the computer. Automatically it will restart. So activation also is here. See here Windows 10 Enterprise. Window is activated with a digital license. Okay, it has to be come with. If it is associated with some other this one, then it will be difficult. Here also there is some backup and so on. If you want to keep up, you can keep. Okay, then. Here, when you go update, you go here. If you want to format your computer, this is the best way. You go here and reset. Okay, reset this PC. Okay. If you are using Windows 10, and make sure that all your files are in the D drive and F drive, and you go to the search bar and give. Reset this PC. First you give reset. Okay, here you see, make sure that restarting now or afterwards. Get started means automatically the Windows will start formatting your C drive. It will not format other drives, only C drive. Means your all your software will be new. Means what all the extra softwares what you have put will be deleted. Only the operating system will be new. For example, this is the problem with Zoom, because whole thing we cannot share like that of Google Meet. Okay, like this, you can format your computer or laptop, no problem, if you have got any problem. But make sure that your files, all the files will be in the this one, D drive.
Yeah, Galaxy S6, you can ask the question.
Father, where do we get this? Yeah. Father, where do we get this license and how can we do this licensing for Windows 10?
Windows 10 system you can get online also. Okay, online you just you search for Windows Windows 10 Pro or Windows 10, depends upon your capacity of your computer. You search and you pay online, they will give you one serial key.
Yes, Father.
They will send to your email. Then I told you, you go to the Windows activation. First you check whether your Windows is licensed or not. Your Windows is not licensed, then only go for license. For example, when they upgraded the Windows 8.1 to Windows 10, now all those who had Windows 8 and 8.1 and 7 license version, automatically that was updated to Windows 10.
New computer, Father?
New
Windows
means
10 version only.
One version. You check, sister, what is there in the this one now. You go to down, search here is there now. You click there, run, run, then give an enter. Okay, in that run, there will be small this search bar. There you type S L M G R
G R
G R dot B B S B B B S
B B S
B B S Okay, I will type in the slot. Yes, and then slash BLI. Oh, sorry, I was using some other. Okay.
Can't see, Father.
Oh yeah, I typed. Oh, SM, SM. Yes.
SLMGR
dot VPS space slash DLI.
It is in mine.
Okay, father, you put it in everyone. Okay, yeah, sorry, sir.
I'll put
now,
everyone.
Yeah, second one now. All should be small letters.
Everyone, yes.
Yeah, that second one. All should be small letters. And give enter, mm-hmm. sister. There yes, you sir. See. What did you add?
Smiler.
You can share your screen, sister. Otherwise.
Smiler. .vbd.dli.
No, father, not Smiler. SMLGR, second one, no?
Yes. Oh, yeah, okay. Sorry. Yes. Okay.
SLMGR.vbs/dli.
Okay, yes.
Yeah.
DLR.
VBS/dli. All should be small letter.
Yes, father. I think there's one more, Father Ben.
Yeah.
Yes, Father.
The last one. Mary
yes.
James.
Okay,
yeah, Mary James, so you can ask a question.
Clarice is also there, yes.
Father, yes, does all motherboard support SSD card?
Sister, if it is I series, all the I series will support the SSD.
Okay.
If you have got a core 2D or dual core or AMD, these okay. things will not support because that is of the older version.
Older version, okay.
Yeah. If you have got I series, i3, i5, i7, all these I series will support. No problem.
Okay. Thank you, Father.
Welcome, sir.
Sisters, Clarician sisters from Sri Lanka.
Last question.
Okay. That will be the last one. Yes.
Okay. Thank you, Father, for all the doubts that you are clarifying to us. And my question is that actually each window settings has its own security, right?
Yeah.
So even the Windows 7 also has it.
Has it, but that will not prevent the virus.
Ah, fine. Okay, in such case, I have that security it has. But yeah. Okay, because of antivirus program, I'm putting it.
Yeah.
Okay.
If you have got Windows 7 and you want to have your, you want to secure your computer, then you put the antivirus.
Because you have said that it is not necessary. If the base one will be disturbed with that additional one, right?
No. I was telling if you have got a Windows 10 Pro.
Okay.
Windows 10 Pro, then there is no problem. It has got inbuilt everything.
Okay.
Okay. Whereas Windows 7 and Windows 8.1, it won't have.
Okay, what about, okay, without knowledge, because of maybe not aware, maybe Windows 10 I have and I'm putting this package also. So it is ultimately disturbing this, what is the basic one. So
yeah.
I wanted to rectify this, what I have done means how to do it.
Have you paid for it already?
Yes, of course, every time we pay, no?
Yeah, there is. You can uninstall, no problem. Remove the software, that antivirus software.
Only that's all. Okay. What already we paid. Okay. Still it is process. Not yet months have passed. Still there is a time.
Okay. You can maybe end up this one. You no need to renew. You
understand. Okay.
Yeah.
Okay then, Father. Thank you so much.
Okay,
thank you. Nice question. Nice answer.
Thank you, Father. Thank you, Father Anthony.
Thank you, Father. Thank you.
Tomorrow, any extra another day. But you are showing some instrument we can show nearer to the.
I see. Okay. Because my volume got output volume got muted, I did not pay much attention.
I was standing there.
No? So tomorrow I will show very close by.
Another thing.
Yes,
but you showed from far away. They want to show nearer to the mic. The camera.
Camera. Okay. Tomorrow, I will show it fast.
Yes.
Yeah.
Tomorrow, someone, you want us all to come in the Zoom in the mobile. And keep the laptop free?
Yeah, for the first at least 10 minutes, these are the technology what we have got today. I have not told. Because of this one. I will take maybe 10 minutes maximum on this. 10
yes.
minutes they can be in this one, laptop, so that they have got a bigger screen.
Good. Yes.
If they are into the mobile also. Okay. See, these are the things where we no need to use the laptop. With this, we can connect the mobile to the LCD projector.
What is that one?
This is...
For van, there is a question from Jamaica, Father.
Yes, Father, please.
Father Anthony Swami, it was really excellent explanation.
Yes,
I
Father.
Have learned a lot.
Yes, Father.
For me, it is a very difficult to look at when we started the computer, immediately the pops of unnecessary things comes in the right hand side of the things.
I don't know how to remove that. Okay, that is you have to go to the Google setting. You are given access to different advertisements. Okay, when we may download something, they will ask just you allow, just you say accept. We do not know what is that, just we click no. Means we are allowing the cookies of that particular website to enter into our account setting. So that will be notification will be coming again and again. So what you do, go to the this one, tomorrow I can show when everybody is there how to resettle. All our last session will be on Google Family. So we will go through thoroughly how to rectify it, how to remove all the ads, how to block the ads, what are the things we need to block, and all those things we can. Otherwise, right click that everything comes now. You right click and you disable the notification over. That will not come.
Thank you, Father.
When it, right side corner, that notification comes. There is a small icon setting. You click there and you give disable. So you will not have any disturbance.
Thank you so much.
I will come, Father.
Thank you, Father Anthony.
Yes, Father.
Clarician sisters are there. Sister, can you unmute? Hello? Sisters, Clarissians, Sri Lanka. I want to ask a request whether you can make the song tomorrow and the initial time, beginning.
Okay. Yes, Father.
Yes, no Ceylon pop song, but any hymn or anything.
Yes, yes. Okay.
You can mix Sinhala and the Tamil.
Yes,
no
Father.
No English. No English.
Sinhala and Tamil.
Oh. Yes. Okay. Mix and sing. If there is any song mixing.
Yes, Father. Yes, Father, we can.
Wonderful. 6 o'clock sharp, okay?
Yes, Father.
Yes, Father.
And end with a prayer. A big group is there, I think. You are all hidden.
Yes, Father.
Come
this
side. I think helpers of Mary also are there, I think.
I see. Okay. We can get them all.
Yeah, they are also good singers. So there are many of my old students in the class, I see.
Excellent. Yes. Thank you, Father Anthony. Thank you so much.
Yeah, good. Thank you, Father. Thank you. So in the beginning, my output volume got muted. I did not.
Your mic is a little far away. When you bend down, it was very clear. When you're talking, bend. Yeah. That was very clear.
No, that's maybe because here also I couldn't hear what you are speaking. No, because my
something wrong. Yes.
That is a little confusion. Otherwise, okay.
Wonderful.
Good, yeah, thank you.
Tomorrow we'll meet.
So tomorrow, we'll get into the designing.
Yes.
Maybe 10 minutes I will take further on this new technology, what all the things are.
Yes. Yeah.
10 minutes, then we will get into this one.
Yeah.
Small change I want to make because in the second day we put on the mobile shooting and all those things. Because we need to give them a lot of input on the designing using the basic thing of this one. So we will take that video and photograph and all those things in the second day.
Tomorrow?
No, November. We'll begin with the photography.
Tomorrow what will you do? Tomorrow
we'll go for designing.
And designing.
So like I will teach them how to make a newsletter, how to make a greetings card.
Okay.
That memo and all those things.
Journal. Okay. You can also propose some small work for them. One page.
Yeah, sure. Now, end of that we will give each congregation whoever attending, no?
Yeah.
Congregation to come out with a newsletter. They can send it to you. You send it to me. Then we will have a little bit of evaluation and we can show them their work.
Good. That's a good idea.
Yeah.
And we can also show to their own provincial. What has happened recently. Yeah. Maybe like Corona time, no? Corona experience. Like they can make a small newsletter.
They can make a newsletter. Maybe 50 pages.
Andrea.
I wanted to start with this, how to put the name first. How to put the name, no? Many they do not know how to, like Galaxy A6, no? They can write their name there.
That's some brought their community mobile.
No, they can put their congregation.
Correct. Congregation, yes. Sister Andrea is CSST. OCD. Can't hear, sister.
Sister, which province are you from?
CSST.
CSST, Tamil.
Which province?
Karnataka province.
Karnataka, which I am also from there.
Well, I have a question.
Yeah, yes.
Now, we usually charge our mobile to the circuit.
Yeah.
And circuit. But they have even these fast chargers when we travel. So is it the same that we can charge with that also? Is it no problem? It won't affect the
No, sister. See, when we buy the charger, no, that which comes along with the mobile, that is the best. Okay? If you want to use a fast charger, you don't buy anything. You see the series of the mobile. Suppose you are using Oppo A2020. Okay? You go to the Oppo, this one, you ask the fast charger of that particular model, Oppo A2020 fast charger. Okay, they will give. You use only that one.
So I can't use another charger, it will affect the
battery. No, you can use, but you will lose your battery. That father was telling you, know, that the battery is bulging out and all these things.
So what I understood is, it is better to get the same brand.
That fast charging also, the same company for the same particular model now, that will suit. Like Oppo A2020 charger, you cannot
use. Father, I have another one.
Yeah.
Supposing if anybody gives a gift.
Yeah.
So we don't know.
Yeah.
Then in that case?
If you are getting a mobile as a gift, there will be charger inside. If you do not find the charger, take the mobile and go to that particular company and ask, I want a company mobile charger. See, the difference between the local and that one is maybe 300-400 rupees difference. But if you lose your battery, 4,000-5,000 you may have to spend.
Yes. Thank you, Father.
Welcome, sister.
Thank you, sister. Thank you, Father Anthony.
Thank you. Yes, Father. Thank you so much.
You can take good rest now.
Yeah, but now it's our supper time.
Yeah. Yes, Father Van, what's time now there?
9:30, 35.
Okay.
Morning.
You finished your breakfast.
I always have a cup of coffee, that's it.
Oh, that's a poor breakfast. But also no milk also, no?
I do. Without milk, I can't drink.
So Indian taste.
Yes.
Okay.
Only need to have a black coffee when I want to study at night.
Galaxy A6 is asking some other thing, I think.
Sister, okay, Galaxy. Okay. Yes, sister, come on.
Sister?
Unmute, sister, yeah. No, I think by mistake.
I think so, yeah.
She must have done. Bye-bye.
Tomorrow we'll see, Father. Yeah, it's already time for you also. Yeah. Thank you.
Yes, okay. Thank you, Father.
Father Ben.
Yeah, thank you.
Good.
Father, if you want anything to be added, you can send it to me so that I can
This is good. Yeah, these are all not known to us. Because we are all not in this line, you know.
Yeah.
So it's good. I'll find out whether anything else is there.
Yeah.
I'll send a circular to them also.
Yeah,
that's better, I think.
Yeah. Otherwise, they can send the question to you and you send it to me.
Yeah. Okay, it's very good.
Okay, sir. Yeah, thank you. Good. Okay, sisters. Good night.
Hello. Yes, sister. Yes, six. Suma. You want to ask something, sister?
Unmute, sister.
Sir, unmute.
No, Father. Thank you very much, Father. I was trying to rename my mobile.
Okay, sister. Yeah. Sister, you see that you click on the participant, no? When you click on the participant and you go to the your name, there is more. You go to the right side, there is more. Click on the more and you give rename. Then you type.
I got it, Father. Thanks a lot. Okay, Father, we have.
Pardon me?
It's.
Clear.
Why is it not clear?
Completely gone.
No, sister, it's not clear.
fiber optics, father, to increase the internet speed.
Now you tell me, sister.
Fiber optics to get the
I think your community silence time, I think.
Can you get me?
Yes.
Can you get me only coming?
Fiber optics, father.
Yes, sister.
What happened to fiber optics?
Okay, I'll ask it tomorrow, father.
Yeah, better. You can write, sister. Don't worry.
Yeah, okay, sister. You can try it.
Get the fiber optics to increase the internet speed.
Okay.
Understood. He's asking, will the fiber optics increase the internet speed?
Yeah, sure. Almost, it's tremendous when you use with the LAN and fiber optics, so you can see L and M and difference.
Yeah. Okay, father. Thank you.
Okay, good. Thank you, father. Meet you tomorrow.
Good night, father.
Good night, father. Good night. You can join us for supper.
Breakfast. Yes. We are extreme.
Sister Andrea, where are you now?
Who?
Sister Andrea. My sister is there.
Andrea is from Maish, Karnataka.
Yeah. My sister is there.
I see. Okay.
Hello, Sister Andrea.
Andrea. There's a question for you.
Okay.
Andrea, where are you from?
She left. No, the same
province. Your sister is in the congregation?
The same province.
Okay.
Karnataka province.
Mm-hmm. She's provincial superior, I think. Provincial secretary, yes. Okay, father. Thank you.
Thank you. Okay, father.
Thank you for the ban. Father Van, thank you.
Yes, thank you very much, father.
Thank you.
Okay, have a good night.
Good night.
Thank you, all of you. Thank you.
Thank you, father.
Thank you so much. Father was asking, where are your community? Which community are you from? Father Andrea. Okay, I think I'll leave. Thank you, Father Ben. We can close. Yeah.